Everyone, I'm Harshit, and today I'm going to talk about designing XMPP for mobile. As many of you may have used XMPP for chat apps or any real-time communication like cab apps or anything. So, yeah, let me just give you first an intro. So currently I'm working on Rods. So it's a search engine where I am actually just a minute. Yeah. So currently I'm working on Draws. It's a search engine. So where I'm actually indexing all the users, bots, and you can talk to them in real time. Previously I was at Amazon, and before that I was at Kiwi, mostly working on Android and some web related stuff. So in this talk, we are going to look at ways how we can optimize XMPP, how we can optimize it for 2G. Mostly there are timeout at different stages, such as when you connect to your XMPP server, it times out very frequently. So we are going to fix that. We chose XMPP because of few reasons. It's still used by GTalk, Nimbus, it's used by GCM. Hangouts video chat uses it. I mean, I have added links to all code and relevant document everywhere in the everywhere in the presentation. So, and the reason we chose XMPP was that we wanted to do many things. Like we wanted to have presence so that if user is online, offline, or if to get the chat states, like if the user is typing or not. So XMPP have an XCP or a module for almost everything. Something for pub sub systems, VoIP, Hangouts is using it, and then for file transfer, we are using it for file transfer. For gaming, Chess Park uses it for real time chess moves, sending notification. So one of the best parts is since it contains module for almost everything, like there are 350 modules overall, so it's very modular. Like you can just pick up whatever you want and you can leave all the other things. One more good thing about XMPP is that if you are using a normal long-lived service, anything, MQTT, WebSocket, or any other protocol, I just know these three. So usually all these protocols works by maintaining a duplex connection from server to client. And then if you want to send a packet from client A to client B, then you send that packet from client A to server stream that packet, and then that server sends that packet, server routes that packet from its stream to client B. So this is how most of these things work. But part about XMPP, it's very modular. Like if you have two clients on different servers, they can still talk. Your server maintains a connection in between them. Since XMPP is so well defined, like you know this is going to be the packet, you can always connect your client A to you can always send your from your client to a GTalk client the packet. So many of you many of us can use it for growth hacking. Like Slack provides XMPP external interface, so if you want to write something against Slack, you can do that. GTalk provides, you just need to know the client's ID, that's it. So here I'm just going to talk about the issues with XMPP. You can see the packets, message, presence, IQ, these are all XMLs. So it's streaming XML. The packets are huge. You can see like the packet on the top is around 300 bytes. So it, and compared to some other protocol, it's really verbose. But there are ways to fix it, which we are going to talk, of course. Also, we opened duplex stream. Before opening that stream, we need to do something called session establishment. This is huge. Kind of you are getting your friend list before that, which it can be like 1,000 friends at once. Then you are getting your presence information. Probably 500 friends are online. You are getting all those status, who are online, who are changing status. You are doing authentication. It's huge. It frequently times out on 2G. So this is something we are going to optimize. Yeah, the main constraints on while designing low memory, the biggest problem is low memory, slow processor, deep sleep mode. You certainly can't keep a wake lock on. I did once and I drained 50% of my battery just using my app. Network connectivity change, like if network connectivity changes, if you are maintaining a duplex long live service, long live connection, it will not work. So you need to design mostly against these constraints. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to club the first three in a section called designing for 2G, and then I'm going to keep the last point, going to take up the last point before, so as to mention serious problem. So every time your connectivity actually changes, you are switching from Wi-Fi to 2G, 2G to 3G, 3G to 4G, anything, your connection actually closes. But it's not marked as closed, or it's not cleanly closed by SMAC, or like whatever library you are using, client library. So the thing is, you have to reconnect again. You have to close your connection using instant shutdown, and then use connect to reconnect again. The biggest problem is, every 2 minutes you have a Wi-Fi switch in India. If you are designing it for 2G, it will go down, it will come up again. And if you are going to reconnect, you are going to get 500 friends again, 100 online offline messages again. So imagine how much is it going to drain your battery. So there are a few ways to fix it. So here are a few optimizations, some tips. Don't fetch all your friend, roster is your friend list. So don't fetch all your friend list when you reconnect. Save it locally since you are using mobile. There's a technique called versioning. Implement stream resumption and TLS resumption. That means instead of re-establishing the entire stream, just reuse the previous stream. And also you can bypass the SSL handshake, that's very expensive. If you're talking to GTalk, GTalk supports a very old version of XMPP. So you need to see if the feature you support, let's say roster or presence, if it's supported by GTalk or not. So for that, you need to fetch something called entity capabilities. That is, what are the capabilities supported by that server? So if you have 500 friends and each have different capabilities, let's say each of them are running different version of client, your client, and you have upgraded something in one particular version. So to support against different versions, you need to get the entity capabilities. It's a good idea to cache it. You can use client state indication if your app is in background. So to tell your server that, hey, I need few packets, and you can ignore or club few other packets. Then yeah, compression and privacy list. It becomes super useful here because XML is very verbose. And when you send streaming XML, your packets are so similar that your size will be much smaller than that. So yeah, the first time you connect to your server, use roster versioning. Send version equal to zero, get all your friends, save it locally. The next time you send that request, either you send it manually or it's sent due to change in connectivity, send the version, get only two new friends. It's going to save a lot of your battery. Also, every time you reconnect, you have 14 to 18 steps for 2G, for minor 2G flake switch, you reconnect again. So make sure that you can reuse the same stream instead of establishing a new stream. It's true for any TCP, like long-lived TCP service. You can design it that way. And in that case, you just need to make sure that your server stores your stream, and thus you can bypass the entire session establishment. The only bad thing about this is that you have incorrect presence. So you are actually online since you are using session resumption, your server stores the stream. So you are actually online for next 24 hours, even though you were offline. So you are virtually you were never offline. So your friend may think you are offline, but you are actually online. So there is a possibility of incorrect presence. So you need to get it fixed yourself. One more thing, if you are using session resumption, if you are reusing the same session, make sure to reuse TLS resumption. We did the same. We tried using it on 2G like TLS. It times out very frequently, 2 KB of certificates transfer every time you reconnect. So, but yeah, so you can use these two mechanisms. But yeah, not implemented anywhere. So it's a good idea to maybe just bypass TLS on XMPP and use some client-to-client protocol, OTR, 4G, or anything else. Cool. So we already talked about entity capabilities. GTalk does not, sorry, GTalk is XMPP, and it does not support client state indication, vCard, and stream resumption. So vCard, if you have a, if you want to see the visiting card of your client 2, you're talking to client 2, maybe GTalk does not support it, and you don't know. If you ask it without checking support, it's going to throw an exception. So it's a good idea to check for every client and server what are things they support. And for 500 clients, it's going to probably kill your users' network bandwidth. So it's a good idea to store it locally and add a local storage receiver to make sure that you clear your data once you are running low on storage. Because it's huge. It's, you have 500 friends. For every 500 friends, you are storing that much of data. Few more optimizations. True for any TCP connection. If you are running your app in background, and if you have many friends, one of them is typing, one of them is sending you an actual message, hey, and few friends are sending you online, offline their status, you really don't care if they are typing, so you can just drop that packet. You are okay with getting late presence, like if your friends are online, offline, or they're late, or you can get their status late, so you can just bundle them. But real time, just so you can tell your server that hey, club, divide my messages into three categories, discard one of them, bundle one of them, and the last one, send it in real time. So this is something very specific to XMPP, but yeah, you can use it anywhere, like for any other protocol. Yeah, again, this packet, IQ is huge, 252 bytes, enables zlib and TLS, 202 bytes, send the same packet again, 90 bytes. So XMPP, one good thing is XML is verbose, very very big, but if you use zlib and TLS properly, since it's a stream, your packet size are going to be very small. So just make sure to enable zlib. Don't enable TLS unless you are sure you will be able to fix resumption. Finally, enable privacy list. As we already talked, XMPP supports server-to-server communication. So if a bot is sending you 1,000 messages, and if the other server does not support rate control, you will get all those 1,000 messages, your battery will drain, your network will drain. So that's true for any actual long-lived connection. Your battery is not dependent, or your network usage is not dependent on just you. It's dependent on whom you are talking to or your peers. So make sure that for any long-lived service, you block all the services and then selectively whitelist only few. Like in this case, we have selectively whitelisted only server 1's client and server 3's client. And you need to be sure that server 3 supports rate control. So if someone is sending me 1,000 messages, server 3 will block on client. You certainly can't block on server to server rate controls. So yeah, so there were a few things. We talked about optimizations, still not perfect. Still does not work 100% on 2G. Few things is 357 push notification. So in Android M, you can't keep your service running forever. So you need to use push notification to wake up your app. And then they have something called stream resumption for push notification. So yeah, you can use that. But yeah, none of these are implemented. So you have to implement it yourself. And certainly, we need a newer protocol for the system, for the design we have discussed here with large assumption time. By this only, we can actually make it work on 2G. Some code pointers. Maxes, I have code pointers at every slides, whatever I have talked about. But so you can have a look at Max's code. Chat Secure is a very popular app. You can use it to talk to GTalk, or you can connect to your GTalk and see how it federates with GTalk server. Then, yeah, you can also use conversations to talk to GTalk, so that will be great. And then Flowstalk, it's the same version of desktop except more technical. So, yeah, if you want to, if you're looking for implementation, you can look there. That's it.
choose QTT over XMPP or which one to choose when?
So actually MQTT is much lighter weight than, I mean it's much smaller than like overhead than XMPP, but if you want to build an app where you need more functionalities, like if you want to build an app like Uber where you need driver's profile, or you want PubSub also, you need search also, Jabber search. So XMPP is kind of more complete solution. So if you want, there are 350 or 360 XCPs there. So for almost all your use case, you will find one XCP. So if you're just trying to build something related to PubSub, I think you should use MQTT. That's much lighter weight. And if you want to do like more search or anything else, then you can use XMPP.
Hi. For compression, what other options do we have other than zlib?
I have used only zlib until now, but I am not exactly sure. I need to check, but I can tell you after the talk.
Okay. Thanks.